Well, with Ben Braun, Roxy Bernstein with you. Cal trailed for the majority of this basketball game today, but found a way to come back and win it and squeak past Seattle U by a final of 70-65. And Ben, it wasn't easy. Cal had to search deep because Seattle U came in with a strong performance.
Roxy, they trailed for most of this game, and it wasn't because they were playing bad basketball. I thought Seattle was playing awfully well. This might have been Seattle's best game of the year, but Cal found a way. You know, they had to stop Darian Trammell in the second half because he was on a tear in the first half. They found ways not to stop him, but they slowed him. So their defense was good. I thought Kuany gave him big, big minutes. He was really solid offensively. He was active defensively, blocked shots, rebounded, kept the ball alive offensively, but, you know, got to the rim. He's quick, 6'9", he's agile. So that's a big plus now for Cal moving forward. And then obviously, you know, maybe the biggest story was Joel Braun. My goodness, did he step up down the stretch of this game and made every right play for his team inside, outside. They went behind screens. He knocked down huge three-point shots.
So Cal, for the second consecutive game, playing without Matt Bradley and Grant Antisevich, and the Bears have a three-game winning streak for the first time since opening up last season 4-0, and it took a strong comeback in the second half to take control of it. Ryan Bentley led Cal with 17, nailing three threes. Kuany tied a career high with 11, and Joel Braun tied a career high with 12 points. There is, on the other side for Seattle U, who were led by Riley Grigsby, the son of former Cal standout Al Grigsby, who had 20. But the Bears get it done, 70-65.